So in this video, we're going to look at two of the controls a pilot can use to adjust the pitch attitude of the aircraft. This is Walter Bislin's Aeroplane Simulator, and below the main graphic, we have a number of sliders that allow us to adjust various parameters while the simulator is running. The first two are the elevator and the trim. So I'm going to run the simulator now at 5 times normal speed so that the demonstration occurs faster, and then move the elevator slider. Moving it to the right is like pulling back on the joystick in the aircraft. You can see that the aircraft begins to climb and the nose pitches upwards. If we move the elevators down, which is achieved by pushing forward on the joystick in the aircraft, the nose of the aircraft goes down. Resetting the simulator. This time we're going to look at the trim. If I move the trim slider to the right, the nose attitude pitches up. If I move it to the left, the nose attitude pitches down. So both the elevator and the trim allow the pilot to control the nose attitude of the aircraft. So you might be wondering at this point, what is the difference between the elevator and the trim? I'm sure somebody is going to ask that question.
So Wolfie, what is the difference between trim and elevator?
That's a great question, Wally. And since there's not much happening in Perth this afternoon, I'll be very happy to explain it to you. So to understand this fully, we need to consider the forces acting on the aircraft. This green arrow represents the weight which is acting towards the ground, towards the centre of the Earth. The blue arrow represents the lift being generated by the wings. Now, aircraft are designed so that the centre of lift is behind the centre of gravity, and that produces aerodynamic stability. We'll talk about that shortly. But if you imagine that this aircraft was suspended by rope at the position of the blue arrow, and the weight is acting through the position of the green arrow, that aircraft is going to tilt forward. What I really need now is a model aircraft. I might just text my handler George at NASA to see if they have one in the Perth warehouse. Give me a few seconds. So George just replied, and the good news is they have one in stock. He's having it sent over right away. It shouldn't take long. There's the door. It's probably Max, the duty driver tonight. Let me check. NASA is a fabulous company to work for. With their $58 million a day budget, nothing is impossible. How's that for room service? What a beautiful model, painted in NASA colours too. This is a Hawker 900 XP. I used to fly an aircraft like this a decade ago. Thanks, George. Your personal touch is always appreciated. So getting back to the main point, if the centre of lift is rearward of the centre of gravity, and I pick the aircraft up at that point, it is naturally going to tilt forward. This is how real aircraft are designed. The force that balances that nose down pitching moment is a down force on the horizontal stabilizer. This is the horizontal stabilizer, and because of the angle that it is set on the aircraft and the forward speed of the aircraft, we have a down force being produced here. So the natural balance of the aircraft is to pitch down. By varying the amount of downforce on this tail, we can pitch the aircraft up or allow it to pitch nose down. You will notice, even on the model, we have what appears to be a hinge on either side. The hinged portion on either side of the horizontal stabilizer are called the elevators, and the elevators are controlled directly by the joystick. If I pull the joystick back, the elevators move up. If I push the joystick forward, the elevators move down, and that varies the amount of downforce being produced on the horizontal stabilizer. So it gives the pilot immediate control over the pitch attitude of the aircraft. I'll show you how that works with a real aircraft shortly. Now, what the trim does is basically adjust the neutral position of the elevators. At any speed or configuration, you should be able to let go of the aircraft joystick and not have the pitch attitude change. If the aircraft is not trimmed correctly and you let go of the stick, it could pitch up rapidly or down rapidly. Now, if you imagine this aircraft is flying along at 200 knots, nicely imbalanced, nicely trimmed, producing just the right amount of downforce on the horizontal stabilizer to balance the pitching moment, and we now accelerate to 300 knots. We're going much faster, so we're going to be producing more downforce on this horizontal stabilizer. As we go faster, the aircraft will naturally have a tendency to pitch up. Now, we can hold that with the joystick by progressively increasing how much forward stick we hold. But we don't want to be flying that way because we can't let go of the stick. If we let go, the airplane is going to rapidly pitch up. So what we do as we accelerate is trim. And what that does is change the overall angle of this horizontal stabilizer so that we can let go of the joystick at any point in time, at any speed, and the aircraft will not change its attitude. So the trim is effectively used to adjust the neutral position of the elevators for speed and configuration changes. So I'm going to play some clips now taken at the aircraft recently. This is the horizontal stabilizer on the Global 7500. You will notice two markers here. Now, I had my colleague in the cockpit assisting, and firstly, he uses the trim switch, and you will see the entire horizontal stabilizer moving up and down slowly. After that, he moves the joystick fore and aft. You will see the elevators moving accordingly. This indication here shows the position of the trim. Now, we want the aircraft to be correctly trimmed at takeoff so that we're not fighting the controls to hold the climb attitude. The takeoff trim setting is very carefully calculated based on the fuel load, the amount of passengers, and also where we have positioned the cargo. Before takeoff, we will calculate the correct stabilizer trim and set it in this window. So here is a close-up of the joystick, and here we have the trim switch. It is a double toggle switch. If you need to trim nose down, you push both forward. If you need to trim nose up, you pull both back. A competent pilot will always have the aircraft correctly trimmed so that he can let go of the stick and there won't be any change in the pitch attitude. So the idea of the trim is quite simple. When you're hand flying the aircraft with this joystick, pushing forward causes the nose to pitch down. Pulling back causes the nose to pitch up. The idea is that when you let go of the stick, the nose attitude should not change. If the aircraft is out of trim and you let go of the stick, then the pitch attitude will change. If you find yourself having to hold forward stick, keep the nose in one position, you need to trim down. Conversely, if you find yourself holding back pressure to hold the nose in one position, you need to trim back. And once the aircraft is in trim, you can let go of the joystick and the nose attitude won't change. So that was a brief overview of how the pilot uses the elevator and the trim to fly the aircraft. It really is just the tip of the iceberg when we talk about aerodynamics, and I could spend hours making videos explaining more intricacies. But that wasn't the purpose of this video. At this point, I just want to give a shout out to an excellent channel titled I Can Science That. Matt is an aeronautical engineer and has been producing a great series on aerodynamics. If you want to know more about the stability of the aircraft and why they are designed as they are, I can strongly recommend watching this video, Stability Part 2. So please head over to Matt's channel. If you like what you see, I'm sure he would really appreciate your subscription. So I plan to make additional videos using Walter's simulator because there is so much more it can teach us about aerodynamics and how aircraft fly. In the next video, I'll show how the aircraft is capable of descending with a high nose attitude. This is something I have seen a number of flat earthers talking about recently, and they have the mistaken idea that the nose of the aircraft has to be below horizontal to descend. I'll explain the aerodynamics in the next video, but look how easy that claim is to debunk. So here is a photo of the aircraft I was flying in 2009. It is a Hawker 900 XP. The type rating is HS125. In the foreground, you can see my airport car, a Kia Optima. The Kia was great because it used to sit outside in the elements for weeks on end, and Kias are built for the harsh Australian environment. The other benefit is nobody wants to steal a Kia. So when I got back from a long trip at 1 o'clock in the morning, it was always there, ready to take me home.